Dr. Urban here. When it comes to exercise and type 2 diabetes prevention, let's explore beyond the established idea and notion that all exercise is good for you. We now know that some exercises are much better than others. A recent study looked at exercise timing, specifically as it relates to diabetics. People with type 2 diabetes took a 10-minute walk 3 times a day, but specifically after every meal, compared to people who walked 30 minutes each day at one setting. Researchers found that the group walking after each meal dropped blood glucose levels an average of 12%. I won't bore you with the obvious value of controlling blood sugar levels. What's the takeaway for those of us that do not have type 2 diabetes, but are nevertheless concerned about our blood sugar levels and the consequences? Why not try to exercise for up to 10 minutes after each meal? You may already have breakfast covered as you go off to take on the day. Let's look at your lunch hour. Why not eat early in the lunch hour, saving some time for exercises of your choosing? Suddenly, stairs, where to park in the parking lot, running errands, etc., take on new meanings and opportunities to add to your exercising. Exercise increases insulin sensitivity in addition to burning glucose or sugar during the exercise. The insulin sensitivity boost can last up to 24 hours or even more. I call that the afterburn. You're not off the hook yet. If you are looking for the best specific exercises to do, new research reveals that traditional cardio-aerobic endurance exercises over 20 minutes, like marathon running, etc., can be harmful to your body over the long haul as they foul up the body's adaptive processes. We now know that too much exercise of the wrong type can age you faster, increase your fat stores, compromise your immune system, and restrict your lung capacity, which is tied to longevity. Hello. All this is new exercise stuff, new information. There is a new exercise program that can be home-based and takes just 12 minutes each day. It is called PACE, or P-A-C-E, which stands for Progressively Accelerating Cardiopulmonary Exertion. Sounds complicated, it's not. If you examine the name, PACE, you will discover the principles behind the PACE exercise program. Or you can go to the link at the start of the description below this video to access the PACE program by Dr. Al Sears, MD. I won't waste your time by stating any exercise will do to prevent diabetes. That may be the case if you have an extreme sedentary lifestyle. However, we now know there are ways to get more bang for your time and exercise buck while saving you money as you work from home. That's it for this video. Subscribe to my channel as more health videos are coming. Now you know the latest about exercise and type 2 diabetes prevention. Click the link in the description below to get PACE. I have found PACE exercises to be helpful, conceptually sound, and easy, saving me time and money. You can do this. Best wishes, Dr. Urban, a PACER. This information relates to exercise and type 2 diabetes prevention. Do not make changes to your healthcare regimen without first consulting your healthcare providers. This is particularly true if you have or suspect you have type 2 diabetes.